Good morning, everybody. It is Wednesday morning, and I have a little project share for you. This weekend, we were camping, and, well, let's just put it this way. It was really, 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 really cold out, and give you a little story. I was doing these, doing them at like 2 a.m, and we ran out of propane. So thank goodness that I have a lot of blankets up our campground. And so if you guys wonder why I feel the way I do, and you guys really haven't seen a lot of me, is because that took a very big toll on me for the coldness. So I've been trying to rest and relax and stay in the warmth, for to say the least. But I have a project for you, share for you. These are cards that I made for Alicia's challenge for the angels. I have 10 here. I have to do one more. I ran out of white card and envelopes because I buy them. Like, I don't have a Hobby Lobby or anything right now, but I bought like 10 cards for a dollar at the Dollar General. So, excuse me. So I have to get another one. I have a brown card, but I don't know. I just didn't like it. So we're just gonna, I'm gonna grab one of them. Probably today I get to go. Most of the stores are now open in Fort Wayne, and that's where I'm going today. I lost my train of thought. Anyways, so open today. So Zach and I are going to make an adventure. I have to get milk and all that good stuff. I'm going to get me some stuff. Just another pack of these. And then I'll use my brown ones over. Okay, so let's get started. So what I have done is I have 10 cards here, and pretty much they're all different. I decided to, I don't know if it was this last summer or this last fall, Zach and I decided to try to make our own, like, colored paper. So we went ahead and tea-dyed, and then we used some food coloring, and we made our own colored paper. And then all I did was I stamped thank you very much, and then every single one of them I have wrote something on. They're about the same. Excuse me again. Oh my goodness. So this is for my 11th one that I have to do. Sorry, my desk is like a total mess. All right, so let's get started. So as you can see, the first one, it has a llama on it. But every envelope has a... Okay, every card has an envelope that matches. Let's do that. All right, so here we go. So here is my envelope. Here's the front. I did washi tape and a brown llama. So then you flip it over, and that's the back of the envelope. Oh goodness sake, sorry guys. And here is the first card. What I've done is two different colors of paper, just pretty much, you know, glued them on, put a sticker there for, like, what are them? Cactuses. Yeah, anyway. Put a llama, so I want the llama front and center. Foamed that little booger up just a little bit. And, okay. And then, oopsie. Different color of paper. All right. Used some stickers. Hold on. I got to make it so it doesn't do that. There we go. Again, you're going to do it again? All right. Sorry, guys. Used some sticker beads or pearls, flatback pearls, and some washi so it matches the envelope. I figured that if I did the thank you, then the angel could use the card for, like, this could be a birthday card, a get well card, you know, pretty much anything, thinking of you card. So that's why I didn't put any sentiments on them. They could use it for whatever they wanted. This one is similar. Again, a cactus, washi tape, flip it over, and there's another. Okay, llama, sorry. So here's the card. Guys, I do apologize. It is early in the morning, and I should have waited to record, but Zach's outside, so I needed to get this done real quick. What did I do? Oh, okay. I went ahead and used some ink, and I inked around this to make it kind of look like the same color as little Mr. I'm going to call him Fred. Then just some cactuses. The only thing that is popped up is him himself. I didn't want to make it too poppy, so then it would cost more to... This is the only card, don't ask me why. More to ship. But this is the only card that I did this way and not the other way. See, there's my thing. So, I thought that was cute. Then, here is the front of this envelope. I went ahead and let's see what I do. I stamped the circles, and then I don't know if you can see it or not. I went back and I colored the circles so they all had like different, not all circles. I just went ahead and stamped and then colored. I don't know, sporadic, I guess is the word I want. Some more washi tape, and then a piece of. Usually, whatever the paper is whatever is going to be on the card. So that will give you a hint on my little thing. If you ever get a card from me and there's like a piece of paper like this, might be that it looks like the card. All right, so I went ahead and here's the back of the card, but I was trying to see if you could see it. No, I did ink around the outer layer, so I inked around and I don't know if you can see that. So I went ahead and inked around the outer layer. Again, I stamped the image. Put some different paper to contrast all this. I figured this paper and this was part of what is that? It's on the paper pad, like the cut aparts. I just rounded it. Needed a little bit something different, so I went ahead and grabbed some foam stickers that I had and put them on there. This is a sticker that I got from the Dollar Tree that them stickers that you can color yourself. The only thing it has is like the gold, so like the pretty gold. So I went ahead and colored it, then I put it on white paper, put the sticker on the white paper, fussy cut, like, around it, and then inked around that, just so I could foam dot that little booger up, just a little, and then the little, butterflies come out of the same pack. Look how cute they are! So, that's what these are. Then I go ahead, and I didn't realize there is washi tape behind here, and then some like eyelash trim. Can you guys see that? Right there. So there it is. Look how pretty. And then I just flip it up, you'll see the thank you thing. But bam, there. All right, there we go. So more washi tape, the same that's in the front. The paper, and then I just thought it needed a little bit of bling and some dimension. Let me tell you on this one, but I will tell you, I took that right there was on the front, and I don't know why. I just didn't like it. So I went ahead and I put it in the inside, and it looks great on the inside. I guess I wanted something more sparkly, I think. So, and some of this, all it says is, like it says, thank you very much. And then I put, for being who you are with a heart of gold to help people in need with nothing in return. You truly are an angel. Thank you again for all you do. And then I signed my name. That's pretty much what all of them says. I thought that was, came from the heart, and I figured that that was how I felt, so I put it on there. Now my handwriting on some of them kind of stinks, but sorry about that. So here we go. This is washi tape. Of course it is, Sabrina. Duh. But it is Maggie Holmes washi tape. I didn't realize I had it. When I went up to the campground. And then I have a holographic butterfly. This is the only thing I didn't actually like. This, the only thing different with the, is this, is it has butterflies. I couldn't think of anything to put on this on the outside without it messing up. So I went ahead and I inked around this, with, I think it was, I think it's called walnut or something. I went ahead and found some little paper. I have two layers of paper here. I found some lace up my campground, which was weird. And I just cut around like the flowers, because they're flowers. Just to give it a little bit of one texture and choose some, look like more dimension. Again, these are the butterflies. I almost said roses. Well, I guess that's why. Butterflies that I went ahead and colored. Butterfly I colored. And then I popped them up just a bit. Not too much. Again, like I said, I don't want to, like, I really don't want, when Alicia has to send these or something, I just don't want them to be too thick. So then it costs more than a kind of a stamp or close to it. Okay. This is one of my favorites. Oh, I should show you that. I have to fix right here. I think I may put some clear tape, because I have glued and glued this, and this sucker does not want to stay on there. It is some washi tape with the word smile. And that's all I did on this one. But the washi tape that is here is, voila, right down here. And I went ahead and inked this whole card. And let's see, what else did I do? So I inked it all up. I put the washi tape down. Then that same lace, I went ahead and cut and made it some more texture. Grab some, I want to say tool, but that's not the right word. Duh. I just said it to you. Eyelash trim type stuff right here. And I kind of just made it look, I was trying to make it look like a nest. And then like the pearls, like with like little eggs or something on the birdie. So then I inked the bird up, and then I just put used a black marker and trimmed her out. I want to say her just because she's pink and purple. And then more of the same washi tape with some little of the flatback pearls from the Dollar Tree. There's another one of thank you very much things with our paper that Zach and I had fun doing the paper. So we're trying to use that stuff up. There's one piece of that paper that he just will not get rid of. It's on our refrigerator. He's like, that's mine, Mom. So I bought. So here we go. Yeah, I bought these cards. Yeah, I bought the white cards at Dollar General, like I said. All right, so I went ahead and grabbed my scrap, trimmed them up, made, and then just put a holographic butterfly. I think it just does something. I don't know. Oh, and you're going to hear Little Man in just a minute. And then I flip it around and I fussy cut, stamped the little girl, fussy cutted her out and colored her. And I thought it was so kind of cute with the little mouse, giving her a flower. Then like this is the paper like on the envelope. I just used decorative scissors at the top just to make it, I want to say more girly, but that's not really the word you need. And then some more, the same lace again, just to give it a little bit of some dimension and looks a little different. And I poked, wow, what a word, popped her up with a little bit of foam dots. And then on the inside, I just made it a little simple and did some hearts. And that is also, I think, yeah, also holographic. I'm going to put that back in there so I do not forget. I have not been to the post office. Friday, we did get a little bit more mail, and I have not opened it yet. Kind of hanging on to some of the mail now instead of opening it the day we get it. So I do have a couple packages. All right, so here's my other card. I'm going to flip it over so you can see the envelope. Washi tape here. Sorry guys. Scrap here and then a little butterfly. Then you open it. Same stamp, but I just made her a blonde instead of a brunette. Did the washi tape different, and you can see there is lace there also. I just love that little stamp. I love like little stamps like this of little girls. I like the little animals that I could start making cards. I've seen it. Some of you guys have some of them. Let me know where you got them. Like, I don't shop online, so if you guys got them online, please let me know, so I can figure out where to get them, so I can buy myself some. So this is the washi tape with two different kinds of washi tape. One has like flower, rose, and the other one has the hearts. So then I went ahead and I want to show you the inside. So again, washi tape, the paper, like just butterfly paper, sorry, and some washi tape. And then I went ahead and then, oh, let's move that, silly me. I went ahead and on one of them cut aparts, I went ahead and cut the roses out because I didn't want the word that went with it. So I fussy cut the best I could around it and put it on the card. So then it looks very pretty with a washi taped. And then I stamped this little hand and colored it up. So then it's like me giving someone a rose. Isn't that pretty? So very nice. And this, I think, fell out of here. Alright, the last two are my husband's favorite, so I saved them for last. So, here is the front of the envelope. I did not do anything in the back, but I went ahead and, again, this is the sticker from the Dollar Tree that all I had to do was color. I did put it on a white cardstock and punched around it so I could foam that up a little bit so it has a little bit of dimension. Another circle that I had just punched out, inked, and used designer scissors and some washi tape on this one. this is the only one that we're going to have of this, because let me tell you, when I went ahead and was doing these, I had a full pack of the ones with the birds and the little flowers. Well, I started looking for them through the night, because I did this really early in the morning, and I couldn't find them. I went through all of my stuff at our camper, and I think my husband and I threw them away. So this is the only one that has like me coloring a bird, and I was very upset about that. You open it up, and some washi tape. And there you have it. And then again, different of our paper, but I just thought it was something different. So this is my husband's favorite of all favorites, because he kind of didn't want me to do it. I'm like, no, I'm taking it. So here we go. Did just a plain light pink washi tape. You flip it over, and it has a textured sticker. This is actually a sticker. Butterfly, do I have to glue you? I'm gonna have to glue his little butt on there. But it's texture, and I think I got these also from the Dollar Tree, to be totally honest. Sometimes they get some good stickers in there. Dollar Tree sticker on that, and then, oh, dun, 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 last but not least for right now is this one. So I went ahead, and again, this is washi tape, washi tape. This is a textured sticker. I don't know what it reminds me of, rubber, to be honest. If that's what I would have to say, like a rubber. I went ahead and stamped the rose out, fussy cut what I could out around. And then I did another butterfly. Then you open it, and then that's the same thing. A butterfly, some washi, and that textured sticker. That's what I'm gonna say. So that is what I have for you guys right now. I have been 22 minutes on Jibberjot and showing you what I have. So I hope you enjoyed this, guys. If today is Wednesday, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week. I am going to get, see, I knew that would happen. Hold on. Rest of your week. Gotta flip that way so I can fix that. I'm going to get these out probably at the end of the week, along with some friend mail. So that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed what you've seen. And guys, I hope you have a wonderful day. I hope you guys had a wonderful Mother's Day. Sorry this is late, but happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. I did not have a very good Mother's Day because I was forgotten. But that's okay. I'm a mom. I know I'm a mom. And I do the best I can. And I took my mom. I asked her what she wanted. And she wanted to go to Dairy Queen. So I took her to Dairy Queen. So I bought myself a Blizzard. So that's what I did. So, you guys, until next time, I'm going to stop babbling. And I love y'all. Thank you for being a part of my YouTube family. If you're new, welcome. Till next time, guys, keep praying, stay safe, and I'll catch you in my next video. Keep crafting. Bye, guys.